And we are on. Moving the mic out. You may be wondering how I can talk without moving my lips. The answer is that's not me. Oh no, the desk is breaking again.
Uh-oh.
This is bad.
We need to reinforce that thing.
Yes, we do. With more than just duct tape.
A single steel ankle bracket would probably do the trick.
Yeah. Unfortunately, that is not an option right now.
Do we have a small jack we can shove in there?
A jack? Not that I'm aware of.
I have some clamps.
And one of our co-hosts is messaging.
Ah!
Hold on a sec.
I have a couple of C-clamps, if they'll help in any way.
Okay, so Brendan and Mabry are on their way, which means that we're going to be getting started a little late tonight, but that's okay. And whoa, there's cords everywhere, stuck on everything. This is a job I need more than two hands for.
Multiple hands incoming.
Thank you. Oh, that. Okay. Now the question is, where do we affix this now? Right here is away from the broken chunk.
Is there anything additional C-clamp can do?
Not that I know of. And it's just one C-clamp that's holding it in place.
I'd be tempted to cram something in there to, like, mechanically stop it from having a chance of going down.
Hmm.
And I see how the fulcrum of the break is, too. You got a screw there that's holding the desk together. Or, sorry, maybe you can just clamp something out of there.
Actually, I have a thought. Can you hold the upper part of this real quick? Here. And exciting television times, I'm sure.
Meow.
Daniel, stop shaking your butt at the screen. Oops.
I believe the technical term is groove thing.
No, Daniel, that is not a groove thing. That is a butt. No, that's not going to work at all.
I think we need someone to work boom.
I think we do need someone to work boom. They better have strong arms that don't get tired.
Like mine are.
I believe it. We just need a different place to mount this thing. Crap.
A stronger place.
A stronger place. Was that your stomach?
I think it was my various intestines doing their job. That's probably the process of duodenation.
You really like that word, don't you?
Duodenate?
Yes.
Yeah. It's an excellent word. From my duodenum makes room for things in my stomach. It enables me to eat pie. That made a little sense without context. But I'm sure the viewers can probably identify the context by thinking for about a quarter of a second.
Yeah. Oh, look at the kitty.
Look at the kitty.
Stop shaking your butt at the kitty. Okay. Drop that in place.
I'm just providing a small amount of upward force.
Okay.
And very slowly tapering off. This... Not only if you're doing 9.5 upward force back.
This should be sufficient. Okay. Let's see what's going on. Ow! Did I hurt my neck?
minimal, but in the event of catastrophe, it would stop at least.
Yeah. Hey, come on in.
Sorry, I'm running a little bit late.
Hey, it's fine. I needed to fix the microphone anyway, which I have just done, so hooray. Timing.
I also need to wear your thumb again.
What?
Your thumb.
Oh, right, to get the thing going.
Hurt. I'm going to go to the bathroom real quick.
Okay.
I need to borrow your thumb.
Did it work?
Yeah.
Okay, cool.
Okay, so what's the deal with Mark's thumb?
It's a thumbprint thing.
That's kind of weird.
I've tried with my elbow before. It didn't work. Terrifying pattern, too. My elbow looks disturbing close up.
So why is there a thumbprint thing on the computer?
Security.
That's weird.
Beats a password unless someone knocks you out.
Yeah.
Wow. Or cuts off your hand. I didn't know they made computers like that yet.
Biometrics is pretty available.
That's kind of
not extraordinarily cheap, but not really expensive either.
Yeah, my last work computer had it too.
Ah.
It's around.
Work computer, gotcha.
Yep.
You have to realize this is the future. Sense. We're rapidly slamming into the possibility of warp drives.
Yeah, I heard about that.
I'm starting to become convinced the Gene Roddenberry duck was actually a time traveler from the future.
No, we've already passed the date at which certain events in his timeline were supposed to have happened.
Vince. He's purring.
Because 300 kilograms of mass energy, the best way to get that is by combining 150 kilograms of stuff with 150 kilograms of anti-stuff.
So, saying is we actually can bounce the graviton particle beam off
the
main
deflector
dish.
That's the way we do things, lass.
Making shit up as we
The Klingon's in the wrong
language. Careful.
Well, posing a threat to us.
Sorry. It's okay.
Are we actually on?
Yes, we are on.
Oops.
We've been on for about 7 minutes.
All right, that was our one S word in the PG movie. Sorry.
Yes, we find where to buy, and we'll just make some crud up.
All right.
Careful.
Oh, yeah. Shoes out of the way.
Yeah, here, let me.
Because there are all the shoes.
So many shoes. What even are you going to do with that many shoes?
I don't know. I mean, I'm a guy. Why do I have this many shoes?
That's
a
very
good
question.
It's quite possible you have more shoes than I do.
Do you have a very large pet spider?
Because that would actually be kind of awesome.
All right, so...
Does the spider know how to tap dance?
Oh, yeah, I should do introductions.
Or roller
skates. Yes. Welcome to Throne of Games, everybody. I'm Mark Amsrai, DJ Amstrak, Brendan Mabry Daniel... And tonight we are continuing Alan Wake. We are pretty close to the end, I think. We may or may not beat it. I don't know. We will see.
Mark?
I'm thinking not.
No?
I'm going to move the bunny.
You're going to move the bunny?
I'm just going to move the bunny a little.
Why is the bunny bothering you, Brendan?
Moving it, sitting it
back
a bit.
Oh, the bunny was a little droopy. Okay.
Yeah.
There we go. Now the bunny no longer obscures the view.
Okay, for those who may have been confused, on top of the TV here.
I love how we move the camera instead of the bunny.
Well no, we have to see the bunny on the TV.
In situ.
It's a perch.
Mm-hmm. Also, the dust on the top of the TV makes it very clear where I picked the camera up from. So I
good
can put it right back.
All right.
Wow.
Practical reason for not dusting.
Yeah.
No. No. It failed. Now we can't do Throne of Games tonight.
Alan Wake crashed. Sorry, everybody.
There'll be
no
Alan Wake
crashed.
Tonight.
Get it? Because he was in car crash.
So, relaunching. What happened?
What?
I don't know what that is.
Why is that sound?
Best of luck with games lately.
Hey.
Are we gonna have to do an impromptu FF11 episode?
That would be boring for everybody.
Yes.
Except for Daniel, apparently.
Her reciteer.
It doesn't want me to touch things.
It clearly does not. You've been touching them inappropriately.
I'm
guessing. I know. I just saw the serial psychosis tag.
Yeah.
Because I just got fired up
here. Eh.
Da-dung. What is that sound?
It's steam, but I don't know why.
Steven's saying something.
Start the game. App already running.
What? No, it's not.
To the control delete.
Or the control shift escape.
Yep.
For the sorcerer who wants you.
You go away. Here we go. Blah, blah, blah. Image name.
Turn it down to brightness.
Why?
So it doesn't generate excess light in the room. And I do not see it running. Why does it think it's running?
I am not unwilling.
There we go.
Secret plot to make Mark think he's crazy.
Okay.
Great success.
So it's back to that. Get that. Bring that up. Oh. And we're good.
All right. We can work, Kotar.
Controller. Yay.
Ooh, and it's the dam.
It is.
Oh, dang.
Are we allowed to say that word?
Damn it, honey.
Someone clearly did.
Just be careful. You might summon beavers if you keep saying this. They might be angry. I love that show.
This way, young man. Follow me. Come, come. The pipe's empty now. We're ready to go.
You have 12 shooting shots.
This way.
Do you have
we
any
need
other
to
weapons?
Go. I knew them both, Tom and
yes, I have
Barbara.
Five.
I had such a crush on you. Such a beautiful
change
man.
Change the bulbs.
I was jealous. There was a part of me that was maybe a little glad when she had the accident. And then Tom started writing and woke the darkness up. He tried to bring her back, but you can't do that. There are no free rides like that.
I'm starting to realize that.
In that case, young man, perhaps you're a smarter man than Tom was.
Oh, good.
Which looked like her. But it wasn't. Barbara was sweet. He didn't understand until it was too late. He tried to undo it, wrote himself, her, everything he'd ever written out of the world. He was so famous. And afterward, no one knew. Oh, Tom. He left only one thing behind in my game, in case it happened again. Insurance. He trusted me. Or perhaps used me a little. Tom knew how I felt. Knew I wouldn't refuse him. I built the well-lit room and put it there. It's been waiting for you. We are characters trapped in a story you have written. And none of us will survive to see the end of it if the darkness isn't stopped. She'll twist the story to her own dark ends.
How do you know all this?
Tom, that's the way he wrote it. He still talks to me, you know, in television, beyond, from below. We have both been touched by the darkness, young man. He saved us both from life.
Slightly.
The darkness stays with you. You sustain. This pipe will take us directly to the well-lit room.
Okay, I need to call my friends, tell them where we're going.
Hello? Ow!
Barry, we're headed to the dam in one of the pipes. Meet us there.
Okay, I'll tell Sarah.
It's Sarah now?
Whoa! No! Sweet love!
Barry! Barry! We gotta go see if they're okay.
They're probably dead. You must reach the well-lit room. This is no time to be a selfish idiot.
That's my best friend!
Well, be a fool. I'll use the pipe. I'll meet you at the dam if you make it.
I didn't have to worry about her. She knew how to stay safe.
Page. Yeah. Anything else? then. Good to know.
Sarah was almost starting to relax. Maybe they could turn this into a win yet. Suddenly, there was a piercing sound, like a table saw gone wild, as 100 birds made out of shadows swarmed into the rotor. The chopper bucked wildly and the board lit up, telling her what she already knew. They were going down. Barry Wheeler screamed next to her.
Slip off there.
There's liquid methane below, so that's it.
And here we go with more birdies.
As far as I could tell, the wreck was empty.
Well, that's reassuring, I guess.
Well, you know, if they'd been taken by the darkness, and we were going to be attacked by them, there wouldn't be any bodies.
Yeah. Flare gun ammo. And a flare.
You know, they wouldn't have dropped those if they could still use them.
God dang it, honey!
Unless, you know, they were intentionally leading you to them.
like breadcrumbs with, you know, flares. Yeah, explosive bread. Aww. Stop telling us about the well at room and show us to the caches, will you?
I don't think you get caches in this section.
I don't think you do either.
I don't think you get them in general.
Oh, hey, Barry! Barry!
City and the Sundance Kid.
I have a different ending in mind.
Yeah, I'm fine. Thanks for asking.
I knew you'd be all right.
How's that?
The Flaming Eye of Mordor?
Laugh it up, funny man. Didn't we have somewhere to go?
Weaver will meet us at the dam.
Might there be something in the...
There might. Yay, more rifle ammo.
Because it is actually ridiculously effective.
You're...
Probably a bad idea. Don't listen to her. Don't listen to the crazy lady. She's crazy. Crazy, I tell ya.
There, I jumped.
Yes.
Chomp it like a chomp.
Of course I'm crazy. You know how you know I'm crazy? Brendan? Do you know how you know I'm crazy?
You married me, but I'm Ching.
That was the joke I was going for, yes. It's true. I married you because I was crazy. About you.
Duh.
One of our hobbies is giving all of our friends diabetes.
Most of your night running uphill while a crazy bunch of demon hicks try to take your head off with an axe. You know your helicopter crash landed in Night Springs.
Night Springs.
Oh, jeez. Here we go again. Oh, I should have kept that gym membership.
You see those lights? That's the elevator we need to take.
Cardio, Barry. Cardio.
Focus, focus.
You can't beat them. You're not.
I watched. I have a flashback.
What the hell is that? It's everywhere!
Nothing moves like that. It's impossible.
Ah, ow! Do something!
He's too fast. I can't get a shot.
Clear down.
There. No, there. Ow, they're all over the place.
How many of them are there? Where'd that one go?
Ah, this can't be happening.
Keep an eye out. They're moving.
Was that it? Are we safe?
That was... Wow. I think we're okay.
Don't say that!
Dang it, especially right after someone asks if
hey,
we're safe.
Hey, Al, I got a bad feeling.
Don't say
Let's
that!
Keep our eyes open.
What the deuce is wrong with all of you?
Wake, call the elevator. I'm keeping watch.
Hey, Coffee.
I hear something moving around.
Maybe we need to calm down, please.
Man, I remember this stuff while you wait for the elevator to get ready.
Oh, I think that's flare gun ammo.
I tried picking it up, and okay, now it's letting me do it.
Yarr.
Okay.
It's booteries.
Okay, I remember there being a lot of nasty stuff.
Yes, no, there's terrible nasty stuff.
So I believe it.
Heads up, here they come. Come. When you have to wait for an elevator,
oh no!
There's always...
douchebag.
The elevator. Error. I'm keeping watch.
I think I hear something moving around.
Error code 15.
As long as it's... Oh. That actually is covering up a bit of the broadcast window, so...
Error 15 regarding what?
It's a steam something. There we go. No, no. Go away. Okay.
Game. Seriously?
Oh, don't tell me it's one of those errors that doesn't actually do anything until you...
Game crashed.
Daniel!
I hate it when that happens.
Daniel, why'd you do that?
Well, we could have, like, pulled it down off screen and left it there. That's what I've done sometimes with that type of error. Like, they happened a lot in Windows 98. Like, you'd get an error if you acknowledged it, whenever you're using playing Finish Crash. If you ignored it, nothing would ever be there. It'd just be there. Some poor programming back then. There.
Well, it was better than 95.
Yeah, especially second edition. Second edition was usable. It only crashed about once every 2 hours. Often less if you really knew how to use it.
That was 98. That was...
Yeah, sorry, I'm referring to.
Okay.
98.
I'm keeping watch.
Oh, good. We only got set back this one.
Yeah.
So.
No, you hit the checkpoint. So
yeah, it totally saved.
Totally saved. Totally.
Okay, next time big guy hulks out towards you, flare gun face.
Also, you might want to equip the floosh bangs.
Heads up! Here they come!
Oh no!
Oh no!
Oh!
Yeah!
Woo! That was awesome!
Coming.
Finish.
We have to
awesome.
Hold the lock!
Weaver's crazy, but she's got something Zane left behind. Something to fix this.
Gee, could you be a little more vague?
Thomas Zane? Seriously? Might as well be Paul Bunyan or Bigfoot.
Yeah, well, he was real.
Easter Bunny.
Let's be careful, okay?
Yeah, my careful would be
coffee. Jeez, I hate this.
Yeah.
Be caffeine to write.
And to, you know, stay up all night fighting.
Wait, excuse me.
No.
Okay, Wake. There's a button over there that opens the door.
See?
Oh, boy.
No one else can hit buttons.
And naturally summons more trouble.
Right.
Yeah, but I'm looking around to see if there's any other pickups.
Don't see anything.
Oh, no, why you knock that over?
Because the reason that only...
Knock over what I want.
The reason only you can hit buttons is because... Summon things. Okay.
This looks like a job for a player character.
I think something's broken. Hold the button down so we can get in.
Oh, you have to hold the button down.
And they can't duck it.
You guys go ahead and find Weaver. She should be in the dam now. I'll have to make it alone through the top.
Okay, wait. Good luck. Don't get yourself killed.
Ow! Please, be careful.
I'll take good care of Barry, Wake. You just look after yourself.
Oh, yeet. Inappropriate gig.
You gotta be kidding me. Thomas Zane knew he had to remove all that had made this horror possible, including himself. That was the only way to banish the dark presence he had unleashed and now looked at him through the eyes of his dead love. But he also knew that despite his best efforts, it might someday return. So even as he wrote himself and his work out of existence, he added a loophole as insurance, an exception to the rule. Anything of his stored in a shoebox would remain.
Weird.
Yeah? What about this game wasn't weird game?
Well. Touchy. It's hard to mispronounce that.
You could say touchy.
Yes.
Yo! I should have gone faster.
You could have tried hiding in there until it had passed.
We're safe here. I have looked after the well-lit room for many, many years now. There is no shadow in the well-lit room. The power is fail-safe, and all the bulbs are numbered and changed regularly based on their make and model.
Right.
She's not crazy.
There's an old army base at Raincoat Point, north of here. It was active during the Second World War. They operated here back then. They must have built this.
Yes, they did. It's my place now. Take it, and I won't need to worry about the room anymore, because 33 and 118 need changing soon, and I don't want to climb up the ladder to change them because it's very late and I'm tired. And if you take it, I won't have to do that anymore.
Hey, Remy.
The page was autobiographical, a memory from my childhood. But I didn't write this. It was a page written by Thomas Zane. None of them were supposed to exist anymore.
Alan, 7 years old, would fight sleep to the bitter end. When he did sleep, he soon woke up, screaming, the nightmares fresh in his mind. One evening, his mother, sitting by his bed, offered him an old light switch. She called it the clicker, and flicking the switch would turn on a magical light that would drive the beast away. To imbue the talisman with all possible power, she added that it had been given to her by Alan's father. Alan never knew him, and anything of his took on mythical proportions in his mind. With the clicker firmly in his hand, Alan finally slept like a baby. Now, almost 30 years later, Alan thought of this as he stood on the rim of Cauldron Lake, the clicker in his hand. He took a deep breath and jumped.
My mind swirled. I'd given the clicker to Alice, yet it was here. Zane had written it into existence in a story I had written.
Or maybe he wrote it all.
I can get to her now. I can finish this.
That page that he had written back then was the start of you. You're a character of things rather than him being a character.
can let the memory
heal.
Remember you with me on that feet. When I thought that I'm
it's too early in the song to do that.
Yeah.
This is like Brendan's favorite writing song.
It's a pretty good writing song. Oh my god! Oh no! A writing song in Halloween! Creepy! I'm gonna get eaten by the stuff I write.
Yeah, sometime tomorrow Brendan's gonna eat your chapter.
Yay.
Turn the page, I need to see something new. For now, my innocence is.
We want to take this intermission to grab a drink. Y'all want anything? What do you have? I've got the
Doctor Thunder. There's also some sleep.
You know what I didn't bring?
You didn't actually drink it.
No, I was gonna bring it. And now it's in the freezer. It's all frozen.
So it's gonna explode.
It probably will.
Oh man.
Freaking pisses me off.
It might only reach the slush stage. You know what, Brendan? It wouldn't have reached that stage yet. Call and ask for
it. Yeah, take roughly 2.5 hours.
It's a plastic ball.
I'll have a darker choice.
Okay.
Brendan got his hands on one of these sugar as opposed to high fructose corn syrup Dr. Peppers. It's actually not a Dublin Dr. Pepper anymore, Brendan.
Plus, you probably smoke me. I've had these once or twice, but it's pretty rare at the same time to take the same amount of pepper. I got 5 hours on it, actually.
It's
yeah,
but once
like
it freezes, it loses its carbonation.
It said that Dublin Dr. Pepper doesn't actually exist anymore.
No, but you can find Dr. Pepper that's made from sugar stuff.
Yes.
It's
yeah,
not like Dublin-style Dr. Pepper.
Next best thing.
And they actually still make it at that particular factory. It's just they aren't allowed to market it.
Actually, they. I was pretty sure that they got their license to even bottle it for both because they distributed it outside the range.
I read about it. Essentially, what happened was the plant had to change hands. But that plant still gets to make it. They don't get to market it separately.
Yeah.
And they can't make a big deal out of it. But the new plant that there still gets to, and the stuff that they sell in that area, because everyone in that area is so used to the sugar
right.
that they'll get really mad and they won't buy it.
Yeah. Okay.
Why do we have to import all of our fantasy power metal?
We have to import just a lot of good music in general.
Yeah. What? You don't like Justin Bieber?
Hey, there are still some wonderful musicians in the U.S.
Oh, absolutely.
We know some of them.
Yeah. But my favorite band that still exists is Finnish. Which, you know, like 10 years ago, I would have been very confused and surprised by that.
Well,
fact.
Scandinavia in general has good music, probably because there's nothing else to do all winter.
And so all they do is just like go back to the well of
previously
bands
on Alan Wake. I wrote a horror story that has come true. Thomas Zane did the same in the '70s.
You will go no further.
If I continue like the dark presence wants me to, the story I'm writing won't save Alice. It's a horror story. No one will survive.
You knew Zane! Thomas Zane! You're the Lady of the Light in the song!
He left something behind to help me. The clicker.
Alan thought of this as he stood on the rim of Cauldron Lake, the clicker in his hand. He took a deep breath and jumped.
I can get to her now. I can finish this.
Pretty much Brendan, but they are also probably, you know, fed upon the wonders of Asgard and so on.
Well, okay, that.
This part is weird.
I had a hangover. My head was about to explode and the light hurt my eyes. I needed my sunglasses and painkillers to dull the pain. In one of my finer moments of self-deception, I swore to quit drinking.
Though probably not this badly.
Oh, and hey look, in a remedy game, you're going to get painkillers. Appropriate!
The sunglasses made the world look bearable. Now I could keep my eyes open without feeling like a vampire in the sun.
Hmm. Sparkly?
No.
I'd like to apologize to humanity for that remark.
You
should.
The pills worked fast. The prospect of being awake started to seem bearable
Brendan,
again.
You know what that means?
Mm-hmm.
When you go see it again,
what?
You're going to have to watch the Beautiful Creatures trailer again.
I'm kind of hoping that
there
the
was
Star
a message
Trek
waiting for me on the machine.
They're both there.
Coffee, maybe?
Coffee?
Nudge, nudge, wink, wink.
I'd check the kitchen.
Butt scratcher?
That's not a kitchen.
Butt scratcher?
What?
Daniel?
What's wrong with you, Daniel?
I'm referring to a thing that exists, I assure you.
I'm pretty sure you're just a little
Something
crazy.
What is wrong with you?
Ooh, let's make toast. We can make our own coffee!
All the coffee.
But it wouldn't.
Chair.
It wouldn't come
Chair.
In one of those beautiful
blue
and white
thermoses.
Chair.
Chair.
Get on the chair.
Carefully, you don't get trapped in the
geometry.
Chairs.
Geometry.
Go on and listen to the message.
You have one new message. Ow! Are you still asleep? Wakey, wakey! You should have your show on your TiVo. If Alice wasn't too mad to record it, that she called me earlier and really chewed me out. Yeah, yeah, we went a little overboard last night. But parties are a part of this business. Al, look, I'm saying this as your friend. She's not doing your career any favors by trying to run your life like that, okay? I'll talk to you later, Al. Watch the show!
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the Harry Garrett Show.
Thank you. Thank you, everybody. We have a great show tonight. I've been talking with the best-selling author, Alan Wake, about his new book, The Sudden Stop.
I love that the HDTV
is
blurry as well.
No, no, it is a good read. Look, I'm going to be honest here. Is that wise? No, but I'm going to do it anyway. I got people who give me the lowdown on books. I'm a busy guy. But this one, I actually read from cover to cover. I mean, I'm a big fan.
Wow, thanks.
Now, this might be a spoiler for those who haven't read the book yet, based on the sales figures, the two people out there who haven't read the book yet. But this last book is all about the death of the main character, the hard-boiled New York detective, Alex Casey. Now, there's been a lot of outrage about why the hell did you kill Casey? What the hell were you thinking, man?
Good riddance. No, seriously, though. 7 years and 6 books is a long time. He was a gloomy guy to spend all your working hours with, and it was a good run. But it's time to explore new things. My next book will be a departure from the old for me.
You selfish bastard. Always thinking of yourself.
Yeah.
Mm. You've certainly given us a lot of entertainment over the years. Now that you mention it, Casey was a gloomy guy. Never had much luck with his love life with the ladies. Was that autobiographical in any way?
Yeah, no kidding. Casey's lady friends tended to die on him. With Casey, it was all about his pain. No, nothing autobiographical about that. I'm a happily married man. My wife is my muse.
Well, congratulations. That's great to hear. So, how's the publicity tour been treating you?
Good. Great. But I gotta say, I'm glad to be back home in New York.
Well, you've certainly been on the news a lot lately. Lots of parties and, you got into a fight with some paparazzi.
Oh, man. Well, that guy was really in my face. I lost my temper. I know that wasn't cool.
You are famous for that temper.
Well, I did also write several books.
Well, your latest novel is called The Sudden Stop, and it's in bookstores now. Go get it. That means the two of you out there haven't bought it yet. Ladies and gentlemen, that's all we have for you tonight. I want to thank all our guests for the evening, Alan Wake, Sam Lake. What's more, do the face for a Sam. And our musical guests, Poets of the Fall. Thank you.
Of course. At least I've been funny. I told myself I could live with that. I didn't say anything stupid, if that's what you want to know.
Okay, Grumpy. You want an aspirin or something?
Are you going to start with me about drinking now?
You know what? Go back to sleep, Alan.
He's being a real jerk to her.
Yeah.
What? Now you can't even talk to me?
Well, this morning I was angry because you said you'd be home at midnight and you showed up at 7 a.m. and passed out in mid-sentence. Now I'm over it. Are you angry?
This goddamn tour. It's gotten out of hand.
Oh, honey. It's almost over, right? We can get back to normal. Then you can start writing again.
I'm sorry, honey.
Alan, you're not thinking straight. Just take a shower and go back to bed, huh?
Yeah, you're right, honey. I'm sorry. Once this is over, let's go away together. A vacation. Just you and me. Some peace and quiet.
Peace and quiet. Yep.
Bottom of a lake.
That's peaceful. It's quiet. What?
I'm getting
into semantics here. Come on.
Somehow, the clicker was the key to the cabin. I had to return to Cauldron Lake to save Alice. I'm going back to the lake to finish this. I'm going to write an ending to the story in the manuscript on my own terms to make it all right.
Why can't you just write it here?
The last page is still in the typewriter. I need to read it first. Everything needs to be just right. Zane tried to cut some corners, and it didn't end well.
Okay, ready when you are.
I'm sorry, Sarah, but I need to do this alone. Barry,
take
her gun. Miss Weaver, close the door when I leave.
Oh. That's
good
right.
Good luck, Al.
Barry somehow
see you
survives.
Later.
Yeah.
Awesome. Yay, Barry.
Yeah, they have a lot of fun
when
teasing
got
you
out,
with his death.
It was warm and sunny. I'd flicked the switch of the clicker. Had it done this? I didn't stop to question it. I had to take advantage of the sunlight to get to the lake. On Zane's page, I'd stood on the rim of Cauldron Lake, about to use the clicker. That's where I was headed.
Actually, we might finish this tonight.
It's very possible. But, let's see here.
We have 2 hours.
You get
two hours. I recall this last chapter is a little shorter.
In daylight, surrounded by the beauty of the Pacific Northwest landscape, it was hard not to let doubt creep in one last time. I could still chalk everything up to a dream, a delusion. I had enough imagination to make up something like this, having been in the cabin all this time, trapped in a story inside my head, gone mad from grief over Alice's death like Hartman had claimed. There would be no way of knowing. I told myself it didn't really matter. My course was set.
And Alan steals another
car. Can I read that billboard?
Sure.
Horizon.
No, not that one.
Up this right falls. Got a map.
Oh, that's it?
Yeah.
You can, like, interact with it?
No.
Oh,
well, dang.
So you can read the billboard, but you can't read
the billboard.
Yar. So can't look the billboard, just have the billboard, shoot the billboard.
Oh, you can shoot the billboard.
Yeah.
It just be a waste of time.
Yeah.
Go.
And now
weave
you can,
it all over the
world. And now you can spend tons of time just looking at the beautiful scenery.
The
Lens of Time, huh?
No! Don't do that!
No, I seem to recall this drive being relatively long, Brendan.
Honestly, don't remember. Oh, well, you should stop here and look for stuff.
Of course.
But speaking of games like and long drives, I hear there's a game with a very, very long drive. Had you been considering that for a future Throne of Games
No.
Mark?
Wait, what?
No desert bus. No.
No.
Because all the death.
There wouldn't be any death.
By the way, what stuff do you have at this point?
A gun and some flashbangs and some batteries.
And some flares.
And some flares. No flashlight, though.
Nope.
What?
No flashlight.
What? Of all the things he could have
chosen
to leave.
It's not daylight yet. It's not daylight yet.
Yeah,
yeah,
you
no,
mean
you
it's not night yet. It is very much daylight.
No.
It's still daylight. It's not night yet. He doesn't need the flashlight, so he doesn't need it. Because he was a derp. I don't know. It's the
Alan
heavy duty
Wake is not very bright.
Don't
cheat.
Bright.
I get this pun on light. Very clever.
Who?
Maybe he figures what the mics are.
Scared
of all
these
things. Yes. Oh. Whoa.
Hello. I'm gonna hoof this.
And have light. How exactly?
Oh yeah.
Light.
Good point. Well, it looked like it might have been something. Yes.
There is a something.
Hunting,
it's a
rifle.
Hunting rifle.
I like those.
Those are good to have.
They go choop choop boom.
No, they go cacao.
No, they go.
No, I'm pretty sure they go capital. Calvin and Hobbes joke, everybody. Calvin and Hobbes joke. Yep, no, that's the right way.
Alright. Oh, but.
There.
I sure did have the frinks like a horse.
Frinks?
What?
What horses
frinks?
Go frinks?
It's Daniel. Why do you even ask?
I
don't ask anymore.
He's like Sander Gowen. Why even ask?
Oh, please don't compare me to that.
Flare gun ammo, flashbangs. Oh, right. You get lots of good stuff in this last one.
Oh, yeah.
Because...
I would hope so. It'd be the climactic battle.
He has
yeah.
to attack the darkness.
Yeah, he does.
I need
but
to cast magic missile.
Actually, that's too weak. Let's go to the Isaac Missile Storm. You do the fifth level, right?
He is Gallstaff. Sorcerer of crashing into things.
I am Gallstaff. Sorcerer of crashing into things.
Good job, Gallstaff.
I prepare a fly every day. That's really bad with me.
Hurt better.
Suck
drive
less. Better.
Drive more good.
It like
okay.
Turns
Alan
deeper.
Has AAA.
Does he? I know that after that crash, his insurance
no.
has
hard
to
left, hard left,
up.
Hard left.
Hard to port. That's a tree.
See if there's a way in the burn.
Burn.
That's an unfortunate way to pronounce that, I think.
Is it?
Burn
oh,
down a bar for five. It's good to be alive. I'm a farmer.
Daniel?
I'm a farmer. Watch me do.
Jump off this ramp. I just
ramp
made
off and out
of
cows.
You're both insane.
Stuff out that field.
You're both just absolutely
that's
nuts.
A pretty big feat.
Yes.
I might go and do donuts in it, though.
Because why not? I apologize to our viewers.
Time to make the donuts!
That was a power slide.
That was a power slide.
How can you even do that in a station wagon?
That's
know.
Not a station wagon, that's a SUV.
I think
you're a van. I don't know what he's trying to
It's
an SUV. Yeah, it's
what
an SUV.
Oh,
okay.
Oh, by the way, this is about to, you know.
What?
Let's go around the tunnel.
Go in there just to see if there's anything, because once you go through, it's
okay.
You go around the tunnel.
Oh, actually, don't do that. I lied.
Thank you, Brendan.
Sorry. That was my bad, y'all. It's my bad.
I'm all the way back here.
Greater butts. Good job.
At least now I know where things are.
Teacher has to listen to me then, won't he?
Different car.
Because this one's red, it goes faster.
It's the biggest and the strongest.
It does make red make it go faster. Wait, why was my orc southern? Red makes it go fast.
Wait, so is this a suburban hunting man?
Dude,
I would want a suburban hunting man.
There's stuff in there, remember?
Yep.
He knows. Stop.
I'm hitting the wrong button to get out of the car.
Ooh, how about a dwarven war van?
I do that sometimes.
By the sons of dwarven war van?
Well, it's clearly a dwarven hunting van. It's painted red, goes three times as fast.
Remember, the main guy in anything with robots or, you know, power suits or whatever is always red.
Yep.
Red is cool.
Because, dude, Char.
Okay.
Yep.
You can't beat Char.
That Zaku went three times as fast as there's Zaku.
Yep.
Oh, I was wondering if there's stuff behind that boulder.
In fact, I wonder if that's where Warhammer got that joke from. He's got them.
There is more boulder.
There's a lot of dark
behind
area
the
behind
boulder
that boulder
was
though.
Another boulder.
They say Durin didn't have a chin.
Behind his beard was another beard.
Another beard.
It was beards
it
all
was
the way
beards
down.
All the way down.
Father Durin
had many beards. Many beards had Father Durin.
This has been Tolkien Durin O'Clock.
I am Durin, King of Dwarves. I have many beards. That one's probably only funny if you have not only gotten familiarity with J.R.R. Tolkien's novels, but have also read the National Lampoon's War of Rings.
Okay, well, since there wasn't anything around that.
No, there was the thermos!
Oh, right!
Thank
you for
thermos.
Reminding me.
Wait till you see Thor's awesome beard.
Yeah, Thor has beard bling. It's pretty great. Wait, have you seen the movie?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
Also, you might want to look at that stuff on the other end of this field.
No, don't listen to her.
They don't know what
because
to
there's
do.
A lot of stuff over that way, like hills and things.
It's possible,
but... It's not.
It's not even. It's not possible.
I crashed into nothing.
There's it was a rock. Bush. It was a very large bush.
You have to be careful how you handle the bush.
I'm not allowed to go anywhere near that end.
I wasn't going to either.
Yep,
gotta go around.
Guess we still this now.
Not over. Around.
Over?
No. Oh, carps!
And you know what you don't have?
There was a link between us. Always would be. I could feel its presence again, getting closer.
Yeah.
Jeez, can we steal
it? You can't.
They're wrecked.
Yeah.
They're also really black. Unnaturally black.
No, they're white.
Yeah, they're white vans.
They're creepily reflective.
They are.
They're like jets.
Birds.
That's in the middle of the road.
It's a bird.
Looks
like a page.
She's a page.
But hey, you know what I
he under that light?
Another car.
Nope.
And a bird.
Wait, yeah, it is a car.
Birds are weird.
But is it a usable car?
Who knows?
Probably.
The Dark Presence was no longer trying to capture the Rider so he could create the ending it wanted. The Rider knew too much. He was too strong. And he carried a weapon left behind by Thomas Zane, something that could hurt it. Now, the darkness was doing everything in its power to simply stop the Rider from ever reaching Cauldron Lake.
Wait a
second.
The dark
place it came from.
Is Thomas Zane... No, that wouldn't make sense. Never mind. I was just considering, with Thomas Zane writing about Alan Wake, and it was...
And Alan Wake writing about Thomas Zane.
Well, and the fact that it was the thing supposedly, the clicker supposedly came from Alan's father. And
Alan never knew anything about...
Yeah.
No. Thomas Zane had two women already.
All these cars. Majestic liquor. Gotta have booze.
So, there's stuff here.
Gun store, liquor store,
oh,
gun store,
right.
Liquor store. Where are you taking me?
This is actually also a hotel.
I would suggest getting that box first.
You remember Agent Nightingale?
Look after yourself, Major! Pitiful.
Box, you said?
You should also check inside that room once I have.
Yeah.
Said ammunition.
I think that the main area has a television.
Yes. So yeah, definitely check back in Nightingale's room.
Based on the signature in the motel register, Agent Nightingale had stayed here, in room number 2.
The Majestic Motel. General information, refundable $100 security deposit is required on all reservations. No personal checks accepted. We take all major credit cards and bank cards. Checkout time is 10 a.m. No loud music, no pets. One vehicle per unit. Facilities are for registered guests only. No visitors are allowed on the premises after 9 p.m. No exceptions. We hope you enjoy your stay at the Majestic. If you're a senior or a vet, ask about our discounts.
He's in room number 2.
Toilet thermos.
Isn't that the bathroom? I thought room number 2 was the bathroom.
Ammo!
Shotgun.
Ooh. Shootgun or hunting rifle? I have more rifle ammo.
The choice is yours and yours alone.
Good luck.
I see a blinky thing.
Yeah, it's revolver. Umu.
Umu!
This had obviously been the room where Agent Nightingale had stayed when he hadn't been busy harassing me.
Flashbangs.
Yup.
Yeehaw.
I'm not sure you can go into any of the other rooms.
That's what you're doing, just to be safe.
Oh. Gamers, obsessive compulsively check everything.
Yup.
It what we do.
Aware. Brendan, you should remember me playing Jedi Knight.
Oh god.
I remember that game.
all the obsessive compulsive checking of everything.
I had to find all the secret areas or I wouldn't have enough, you know, force powers.
Yep.
Remember? That
yep.
was how it worked.
Yep.
Can I drive the boat?
No.
Dude, what?
You are not Poonikins. You can't drive boats on land.
It's a land boat. Let's go die another day with this.
Land boat.
Hovercraft.
Guess I'm dying
Sigmund Freud.
Sigmund Freud. What the hell was that even?
That was the deuce. I don't even...
Pyramid!
Shoot.
Bear camp pyramid!
Bear
camp
pyramid! Pyramid! Shoot.
Right.
Not with the hunting rifle, though.
No. Although I could go grab the shotgun and do that.
Oh, that's cheap. I love it.
That's very cheap.
You totally should have done it. Why didn't you do that, Mark?
I don't know.
Yeah, geez, Mark.
You could have conserved so much more.
That one bullet. That one bullet.
Yeehaw! They need so badly later.
What's that wake boy got?
Hey, look, there's light.
So there is. What else is there?
Is that a thermos? Where? Oh no, check in there so we can see what's in there. Maybe a glass.
Maybe there should be glasses. Maybe there should be glasses.
You see? Might be something. Or maybe not, maybe you should just go.
Yeah.
Probably better just to go.
You're
hearing Liam Neeson kill people to get his daughter back? I refrain from making that.
Oh, crap!
Yeah, it's time to run.
Oh,
yeah,
Bridget.
Also this part sucks.
Bridget.
This bridge?
Oh boy, do I.
What was your favorite
this
part
way?
Of this game?
No, you have to do the bridge. Kill that guy first.
Yeah.
First spot.
Achievement right away.
Sucker.
Here we go.
Play clock. Watch.
And have you got a flashlight now?
Yep.
Heavy duty lantern.
Good.
Or at least a lantern of some sort. No dice, can't get in it. Oh, but look, flares. Flare singular.
Frere.
Frere Jacques?
Freya. Come on, let me through.
Go around the other way.
I don't want to go around.
Well, too bad, because you got it.
Behind you and throw a flare.
Yeesh.
I was hoping to just dodge through.
No,
yeah, you're
going
to have to destroy
everything.
You can't dodge through on this part.
Oh.
You
yep.
just have to man up and kill things. With light.
Yo.
What the hell?
look at the there. There's more.
It has functioning headlights.
Wait, do we? Was the Thomas thing maybe in one of the extra episodes?
It's 1979. Wait, we're here.
Thank you. Oh yeah, definitely shoot that knife.
To just hit those things as I went. But that didn't work too well.
I think unless you just kill each group as they come, they're gonna have more on there.
Was a graveyard of things the lake had claimed in one way or another over the decades. The dark presence brought them up in its wake, scattering the rotten, waterlogged hull of an old boat here, the remains of a long-ago crashed airplane there, trees shattered under the impacts. The earth groaned. It didn't even notice.
Yeah. Do I want to go back and check for even more ammo just in case?
Probably not.
There might not be anything, but worst case scenario is you just reload the checker and say screw it.
Why didn't I take the shotgun?
Well, we didn't know, did we?
Nope.
This game probably run into no action soon.
Really?
Yeah. Lumpy.
Lumpy jazz.
Lump action.
Nope, nothing there.
Oh.
Glass. Let's find the light. Glinting off something random.
I can't get up there.
You and your weak riderly legs.
You were close.
So close.
Noodly legs.
Cash.
Oh.
I don't know.
Cash. Whoa! Shoot! Whoa!
Hey.
What the frick? Oh my god!
There's two of them?
There's two of them!
No, I got this.
Holy shirts and pants.
Shiza Manelli, what was that?
Bad dudes.
They were bad enough to rescue the presidents.
No, don't get in the truck yet, because remember.
No, I was just standing in the line.
They were bad enough dudes to rescue the president. Your wife has been kidnapped by Taken. Are you a bad enough dude to rescue your wife?
Are you a bad enough writer?
Are you a bad enough writer?
Oh, he's terrible, believe me.
Okay, well, I guess both those arrows were pointing at the same thing.
All right, go inside the place.
Oh, yeah, there was a door.
There is a door.
Read. All visitors must see the yard manager. You must sign a liability waiver before entering the yard. If you're looking for a specific part, ask for it first. For you pull it, you must bring your own tools. Wear protective clothing. Warning, junk piles may shift. Hazardous area. I almost misread that.
Or
hunting rifle ammo. Well, at least it has ammo.
There might be a shoot gun around here somewhere as well.
Coffee!
And it looks like... No, that was...
Make some batteries, make some...
Flashbang.
I guess.
Never had too many of them.
Yummy!
Yes.
Rare.
WD-40. Why not take that? A lighter, WD-40, flamethrower, all the light, and fire.
Maybe he doesn't have a lighter.
You know what you must do.
What, seriously? Come on, Alan. What are you hitting? There we go.
Oh, wait, no. That's the boy that you cannot come back from. Because of your googly rider bags.
Chair. Yay, achievement unlocked, canny.
I get it.
Okay, I guess this is what I have to do.
It is what you have to do. It makes the gate go that way. Oh, also, watch out for noobs.
Giant spider. Come on, spiders. Yeah, welcome here.
What's that shiny thing on the table? Is that battery's ease?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah,
he's hanging out.
Here,
do
just
wait. Handy.
Handygun.
I'm a funny guy.
You make joke.
I make joke. It's funny. Make you laugh.
Face kept crooning sweet nothings, sugar-laced with poison. He put on the suit, untied the monster from the chair. The thing in his arms thrashed weakly, but he held fast. He stepped outside, off the pier, and into the dark water, a sinking pinprick of light descending toward a bottom that never came.
Letter.
Run over the flare, see how that treats you.
thing that's on radio.
Stop the thing you look at. Because it might be a thing you can climb or get the thing. But
yeah, it looks like a well pump style window.
Oh, yeah, nope, I lied.
Nope, nothing here.
I lied. I'm a liar. You shouldn't listen to me. Oh my god, Mark, behind you!
Barrels.
That's right. You can't trust those.
As if I knew what I was doing. I didn't. I was operating on the shifting logic of a dream. I had to fight my way to the lake through the horrors of the night. I had to flick an old battered light switch imbued with childhood magic. I had to write a happy ending to a horror story. I had to save my wife from the dark prison she was being held in.
Oh yeah, there's also this part.
Follow the yellow bait arrow. Follow the yellow.
There.
Yeah.
Nerd. Making things, and one of those industrial lights turn you on.
Which industry?
Ooh.
Lump action shotgun.
Give her to you.
Thank you. these buildings a bit more because they have ammo.
Got the one with the drum. No, it's pump action. It's not the one with the drum. It's still
I love the one with the drum. Yeah.
That was covered.
What do they call it? Like an assault shotgun or something?
Something like that.
Well, not getting back that way.
Nope. Sir, shotgun, you get the shock troops.
I found myself in was unlike anything I could ever have imagined. It wasn't solid. It flowed. It was conceptual and subjective. For someone else, an artist in another field, it would have been very different. I could sense the story of the manuscript all around me,
right.
The words and ideas floating in the air, poised to become real.
I'd forgotten that part. It's really cool. You're gonna love this.
You'd probably drive better. Someone in hard science is completely mad.
More things to push.
I want to go on the ride.
That was needlessly distracting.
I could see Mirror Peak in the distance. That's where Cauldron Lake was.
I'm shooting slugs.
Focus. Focus. Birds.
Bird focus.
All the birds.
Better get ready to birds.
Bit rad.
How about bird? Birds are weird.
Mine card.
Yes!
This could be
is.
Awesome, this
Woo-hoo!
Could be horrible. I don't know which.
Time for fun times. Stand by the birds.
Yeah.
Butt climb! And now you can hear it.
Ooh, go down there. Oh, wait, not yet. Now push that thing. Oh, wait, you can. Oh, wait, yeah, you can. We're done with that.
Don't go that way?
Not yet. Go down there.
Yeah, there's like a checkpoint to loop.
Fat.
I believe that was an item in a game at one point.
Mm-hmm.
It has been.
What game was that? Shoot. Oh,
Munchkin. That card, the fat loop.
Okay.
Oh. Is there absolutely
Dungeons of Dreadmore? Dungeons of Dreadmore had a such an item as well.
Or was there just two paths? Oh no, it's a cache. Okay.
Being able to hear those birds sure makes you feel nervous, doesn't it?
Cache.
Shotgun ammo.
That's a lot of flare gun ammo now.
And a lot of shotgun ammo.
A lot of flashbangs.
I gotta ask myself, where'd those birds go?
They're waiting.
I don't know if the microphone picked that up or not. I hope it did.
He said they're always waiting in a really quiet, creepy voice.
Thank you, Rick.
Always wait.
It was subtle.
Like you're not being right now.
So, for like the 2.5 people who remember the door.
You dumped.
Good lord.
I find your lack of death disturbing.
Yep, I'm just gonna disappoint you guys.
Because they're not the only ones who can spawn camp.
Yep.
You took him down with a passive.
Hey.
That's how you do it.
That's coffee. Called not breaking a sweat, is what that is, right there.
Coffee.
Yes, coffee. Coffee good.
That's called in the jitters, huh?
Whoa!
Up through the bridge, more like.
Is that cheap card?
That was cheap.
Mind you.
Oh!
Which makes sense, because it's birds, and they have cheap, cheap,
cheap. Oh my god.
Need to return.
flare gun ammo full.
Wow.
Revolver ammo full.
Makes you wonder what's just around the bend, don't it?
Is that
yep.
There's something on that rock behind you. Behind
it.
I think it's actually coffee or something.
It's coffee. No, it's not coffee. It's just a
water can. Thank you.
Oil
can!
My mind went there too, Brendan.
What can?
Rhymed can with can. That doesn't work.
Or a frying pan.
That's better. Of course, if there's a frying pan, you know what happens next.
Frying.
No.
And then a party land.
No, no. Because you have to go out of the frying pan and into the fire. I went to find that.
Well. Come on, stay put.
bad.
Bam.
Bam. Bam.
Basic calculus was so freaking reinforced the other and made it really
easy. Okay. So it didn't get like repetitive and annoying?
No, it was like here's the math, here's the application.
Oh, well yeah, that would be kind of whoa. Also that.
See, there was no advantage to me taking calculus. I'd already had 4 years of math. High school math, which was the most advantage I could get from it unless I took AP. My school required that you have an A. An AP level. There was no benefit to me taking it at less than an AP level, and I couldn't take it at AP level, so I said, no more math.
Yeah, trig burned my face in high school, so I wasn't able to take Reiki calculus either.
And I haven't taken a math class since.
Yeah. You miss out on a whole lot of fun.
The way you say fun, Daniel, it doesn't make it sound fun.
I mean, in a dwarf archer sense.
Yeah, that thing about fun.
I've largely forgotten how to do more than, you know, simple arithmetic.
N stands for no survivor or something.
So there's that part in the book as well. You keep saying that word. Okay, no, I think you know what that word means. It's just the fun.
No, wait, I can't define fun. We not with our rating.
What do you mean you can't define fun?
With our rating? No, I can't.
Oh, okay, that's true.
Anything that makes you go, wee!
Drinking a lot makes me go, wee.
But you ain't got drunk yet.
Oh, potty humor. Catering to the serious adult crowd on Game of Thrones.
Throwing We're games. Responsible adults.
Yeah,
throw to games. Sorry.
Thank you. The darkness wears her face.
Again.
Yay.
Oh, there's a thing.
Our favorite.
12 flares.
How many flashbangs can we carry?
Well, Let's check.
A lot, apparently.
How many of those?
I have 12 right now.
That's pretty great. Ooh, sure.
It was like 26 flares, I think.
Like shirt gun? Like a t-shirt cannon?
Hey. Shoot gun has lost its appeal to me.
The darkness
controls the taken. These are not newses now. We know these.
I swear, the star sign is so bright you can't read things with it.
Counterintuitive.
Don't you wish you could get in that car?
No.
Oh yeah, and start driving it.
Yes.
Steal the rust bucket.
Don't you wish you could drive that antique car?
Rust the steel bucket.
If it were in better shape, sure.
I think it would be hugely entertaining if you were allowed to do that.
So apparently I have to go this way.
Yeah.
Yep,
choke point.
Ow!
Oh!
That
looked painful.
Times. And now Ali Lake has a concussion.
He's had that since the beginning of the game.
Now he has two.
You have multiple concussions? I think
yes.
You get a worse concussion.
Yes, you can take damage to multiple sides of the brain at once.
Overachiever.
Are you sure that wouldn't just mean you have a single worse concussion?
You get multiple concussions on different. You get like a different concussion on a different load.
Oh,
like you take
true.
A forward concussion to you know, like the cerebral cortex.
These fun.
Oh wait,
yeah, those are about.
And you get a sideways concussion like your temporal lobe. Brain science.
Science.
It's
brain.
Not just for zombies anymore.
I'm pretty sure it was never just for zombies.
But
holy
toots,
you have 15 flashbangs.
Yeah.
And 12 of their gunshots.
Because of course. Oh shoot! All the flashbangs and all the flares.
Forehead damage.
Okay, so.
That hurts so much.
There was a flashbang in one of those, wasn't there?
Yes, yes. The building is new to explode.
Ridiculous.
I think we aren't going to get to the really surreal stuff until next week.
Aww.
I'm sorry, Mark.
It's okay.
It's like I'm just gonna go off and tell the flare to stick around.
Get all the guns ammos.
Thank you.
land of the slow elevators.
Okay, go. Okay. You're good to know.
In the line. Slowly turn.
After Zane had gone, I stood alone in the shifting dream that was the dark place. I had to find a way to the cabin. I had written myself a way through this place in the manuscript. I followed the idea of a path. I had written myself across the ocean that blocked my way, and with that, there was a bridge to the island beyond. The idea of the cabin flickered in the underwater darkness. I willed the cabin to be real, and it was.
Killed him!
Nice. Well, seems to be working. Seriously.
Yes.
even see that.
Oh.
Thousands of butts.
Oh, well, you're...
Baby, you were having a bad dream. It was just another nightmare.
No.
Everything's fine. You're home.
It wasn't a dream.
Everything's fine.
Turn the lights on. Turn the lights on!
Shh, baby. The power's out. There's no light. Come back to bed, and I'll make you forget all about your fear in the dark.
My fear? It's your fear. Why aren't you afraid? You're not Alice. Turn the lights on now. Where's the clicker? What did you do with it?
Alan, you're scaring me now. Come back to bed. Have you taken your pills? Do you want me to call Dr. Hartman? I read your manuscript. It's brilliant. Departure is your best work yet. You're a genius. I'm so proud of you. Come back to bed. We'll talk more about it in the morning.
Thank you.
into the cabin. It stands in your way. It won't let you pass. It has no heart. It's filled with darkness. It must fill its heart with light.
But it has
the
no heart.
Flashback.
You must fill the thing it doesn't have.
Don't mind him. He's Mr. Scott. Your friends will meet him when you're gone.
So the devil?
Use the clicker.
What? Don't blame him. He's just a friend. Cool concepts. Double ball.
You're not my Barbara.
Tom, let me go. I promise to be good. Please, untie me, naughty boy. I will help you write your masterpiece. I will love you forever.
No, you're not Barbara Jagger. I made a terrible mistake. I should have never written you back. You came back wrong. Your heart is filled with darkness.
Put that knife away, Thomas. Put it down.
I'm getting darkness. I'll cut it out.
Oh!
Take you back to the depths of cave run.
I will the cabin to be real.
Filled with darkness.
No, it says leg burn like that.
Your husband refused to do as he was told. All he had to do was write what I wanted him to write. Now it's too late. It's...
Now you will never get her back.
Oh, you can see the place where he cut out her heart.
I am much older than you.
Older than your first work of art. I will find a new face to wear. Someone else to dream me free.
Click.
I could feel Alice's presence close by. I understood what I had to do now. I knew how to write the ending to Departure. There's light and there's darkness. Cause and effect. There's guilt and there's atonement. But the scales always need to balance. Everything has a price. That's where Zane had gone wrong. There's a long journey through the night back into the light.
Out again. Episodes that really support it after this.
Yep, DLC.
Okay.
But it's still...
I probably have that, but...
You probably do. But yeah, still, it's more than a little weird.
Oh, I'm sure it is.
Because that is a...
Ground control to Major Tom.
Nice.
Ground control to Major Tom.
That was a really weird way to end that.
Take your protein pills.
Someone had to stay behind, I guess.
Helmet on.
No, but it was an ocean.
I don't know. I guess the,
commencing countdown engines on.
Ooh, what are those?
Check ignition and may God's love.
But like I said, it helps when you do the episodes.
Okay. Yeah,
it's still
yeah.
You've really made the grade.
And the papers want to know whose shirt you wear. Now it's time to leave the capsule if you dare. This is Major Tom to ground control. I'm stepping through the door. Stars look very different today. For here am I sitting in a tin can, far above the world. Planet Earth is blue, and there's nothing I can do.
I should. And I'll let the credits roll. You know,
only fair to the folks who created this fine game to pay them the proper respect. And to David Bowie, because I mean, seriously, you can't stop David Bowie. You can't just.
No. Sometimes you can stop David Bowie because he has no power over you.
Yeah, but you have to let him finish singing first, though. You notice you let him finish singing.
Yes, absolutely. Gotta let him finish singing.
Pronounce an umlaut over an A, anyway. I know what it is over a U, but...
I don't even know, man.
To me, it always is just kind of a way of making the vowel... It gives that vowel that different sort of sound.
Yeah.
But I think the effect to it is the same regardless of which vowel it is.
So it would be like, ah?
Yeah.
Okay.
Ah! Oh!
Throw him in the mungeon. Sorry.
Is that like the fungeon?
I want a fungeon.
Oh, I want a fungeon too. It's a fun dungeon.
Jorg.
Turbo became such a...
Yeah.
Dude.
Yes,
boys.
What are these ghost maps?
Ghost brothers.
He geeks.
I geeker, sir. Sorry to Kevin Geeker for making fun of me there. That's not cool.
Yeah. Well, I mean, we're not making fun of you. We're making your name is kind of funny. I mean, come on. I'm sure you're a perfectly cool guy. So.
You know, Mark, you have a normal name.
Yeah.
You probably never had people make fun of your name in grade school, but I'll tell you, it's really, really painful. So there may be this guy out there who spent his entire childhood having his name mocked by other children, and now there you are on YouTube for eternity making fun of his name.
Well, he's used to it by now, so I mean...
Oh, butts. Steve Butts, for instance, actually.
Kevin Guyden Darby.
What?
It's in quote marks. It's a nickname.
Yeah, well, obviously, but dude...
He's a side story.
Kevin Darby. He's
hey,
not Kevin.
It's Volt. No cactars allowed.
No cactars.
Sergio Juarez.
John Papa Bird.
Papa Bird Fountainhead?
What?
That's the worst nickname ever.
Why,
Dubby.
Why
Dubby.
Would you,
Dubby.
I think it's Dubby Coon. Fountainhead.
Oh no, now I'm doing it too.
This is a very like multi-ethnic development team.
It is.
I'm just gonna say.
Although I guess some of these people are in charge of localization, so that would make sense.
Yeah.
See,
yeah.
It's like Osa says, his name was so boring that he had to add guidance. And Clumsy Robot says, Leo, it's not that the controls so the aiming for boring have this idea of it Plants vs. Zombies?
Thank you, Clumsy. Joyce Wee!
What's Dynamedian?
I don't know,
but it's a good name.
Dynamedian!
Statskalpala Hale.
Alan Rangan. I wonder if he's related to other people with the name Rangan.
Nancy McCloud.
Of Rankin and Bass?
Yeah.
I don't know.
Utterly plausible.
I get. Wait a minute. Wasn't his name Alan Rankin and something Bass Jr.? Oh, I can't remember. Hold on.
Aaron Burr.
That is not Rex Snook. I wonder if that was really the.
Boy,
name.
you can tell people who grew up in the early 90s. Like,
yeah.
Right there. Aaron Burr.
They know that commercial.
Mm-hmm. Yup.
Yeah.
So we need to add quotation names to everyone. Serial Panzer Psychosis. Am's Phaser Rye.
I'm a phaser?
Eggs tree use protect from stray phaser bank. Thanks, Lovesy.
Ooh, I need to figure out what something in quote marks I need to add to my name.
Clumsy the Clumsy Robot.
Okay.
J. Black Knight Spade. Butts. Thanks,
no. Arthur Rankin Jr. and Jules Bass, not Alan Rankin. Although
but
it might be some.
Could still be related.
Oh no. Hard to see.
You're sounding Canadian again.
It's hard to see.
Daw, Remy. She's down on the floor here in front of us, just like stretching, and it's so cute.
Remy, murderous.
We could get the webcam and show everyone.
Yeah.
You know. Remy's fuzzy belly.
Or we could just not.
Stretchy pointy beast.
I can't believe how much bigger she is. She no longer looks like she's, still a kitten.
She has a lot of fluff.
A lot of fluff. I thought she was getting kind of fat, but...
It's both.
I've noticed that in large part, her fur has just gotten...
Now, I mean, if you put her next to Vince, she still looks tiny.
Yeah.
But I mean,
you
if put you
most
put
most cats next to
if
Vince.
If you could put a hippopotamus next to Vince, the hippopotamus might well look tiny.
It would look like a small hippopotamus, at least.
Like sitting next to a house cat, you'd think it's kind of small, yeah. But yeah, Vince is a freaking Brobdingnagian cat.
See, there's Dynamedian again.
Yeah.
So they do like the Night Springs TV show stuffs, or what?
I don't know. It mentions a whole lot of like orchestra and recording engineers. It's probably one of the sound studios.
Oh, there you go.
Yes.
Sound Deluxe. I think Dynamedian sounds better than Sound Deluxe.
Sorry, Sound Deluxe. Dynamedian has Dyna in it.
Tada Owl.
West.
West. West Side. I don't know. Dude, I'm too white for that.
No.
Yeah.
Bad Mark.
You are very, very white, Mark.
Who's me?
Yes.
In fact, I don't know if Brendan or Mark is whiter.
That's a good question.
I don't know. That would be hard. Lot of your
tootsie. Chance wheeze. That's a sad thing. Chance wheeze.
Wow, multiple umlauts in one name. Kristen Sjordstrom.
Sjordstrom.
I tip of the hat.
Sjordstrom.
Metric. That's kind of a cool
like
name.
Yeah.
Cornelius Pfluger.
Awesome name as well.
That's wonderful. I love that.
Captive Motion. Also.
Adam Craver.
Halo
Guernica? Okay.
And Dominic Cielli. Perspective Studios.
They're good at seeing the big picture.
Evan Eldridge.
Brian Eldridge.
They must
be related.
I wonder
if there's a relation. Hard to say.
John Nuzzi. Nuzzi. Lloyd Floyd.
The Hitchhiker.
Tor. Jeff Cantor.
I love the Anderson brothers. I'm just saying.
Yep.
They are one of the high points of this game for me.
Yeah, they're pretty awesome. Agent Nightingale. Jackass.
Villi? Really?
No, these are like
Ilka Villi.
Yeah.
Yona Yarvinpah.
See, that surname just makes me think of the little things in your small intestine that absorb stuff.
Miko Porhola. All the umlauts, wow. Linus Neistat.
Man, this is a long set of credits.
This is a long set of credits. We might not have time to get to the check on the other stuff before.
Well, we
can
at least find out if we have it, I'm sure.
Papadopoulos.
Credits. They're like
Papadopoulos.
Look at them go.
We've got special things. We may be near the end.
For your contribution to the project, these three, and also these guys for some reason.
Jan Allenpaa.
Rex Cora.
Otso Makinin. Ulla Jarvio.
Wolfgang Enge.
Chili Vodka.
Someone has the nickname of Chili.
The nickname Chili Vodka.
That's awesome.
Mika Osterberg.
Countless others over the years.
Yeah, Potem Muse, Children of the Elder God. Oh, Old Guard's Bad Guard.
Coconut.
Yep.
Yeah.
Put the lime in the coconut and drink it both up.
They're the same people. And they are awesome.
Space Oddity.
Yep. because David Bowie.
Wait, there was Depeche Mode in this?
At some point.
Physics.
Havoc.
Because physics.
You know, their involvement in this game probably totally bought them their audience on this side of the Atlantic Ocean.
Alan Wake's journey through the night will continue.
But not tonight.
James Bond will return.
Alright, so do I have
episode
or extras?
Might be under extras.
Do you got Dulk?
Nope.
No, go under episodes.
Check episodes.
Yeah, special.
Yep, the signal and the
writer.
There you go. Those are the things.
Okay. So, next time we will hit those. As far as scheduling goes,
we'll hit them hard.
We haven't settled hard on what we're doing yet. We might repeat Alan Wake next week, just so we can finish it before the year is up, and we can pick up a new game on the other week, or we can pick up new games both weeks for the new year. Which, you know, that seems like it'd be a good way to do it. Or we might just switch back to the other week as usual. We'll have to figure that out. The game that we would be starting for the next week is a PS2 game called Tulip. If you've heard of it, you know how bizarre it is. If you haven't heard of it, you will find out how bizarre it is. Because it is really, really weird.
What is it?
The short version description of it is that it is a kissing RPG.
Huh.
It not to be confused with the dating simulator. Nothing like that.
Not remotely.
It's basic premise is your young boy moves to this small town with his dad. You're both really poor, couldn't hack it in the big city. And on the way there, you have a dream about meeting a beautiful girl your age who some weird tree thing says that you will spend the rest of your life with. And you wake up, and there she is living in this town. However, she will not kiss you because you are not good enough. So you have to pretty much kiss everyone else in this town to become a better kisser so you can kiss her.
Wow.
It is so weird. Seriously.
I've seen
but it's hilarious.
Fix everyone's problems by
so,
doing this.
Yes, you do.
So, I'm going to take a wild stab at this. This game comes maybe from Japan?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay.
It is very, very Japanese.
I'm shocked.
Yeah.
Exceedingly Japanese.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so what do you think?
I liked it. I'm looking forward to the extras afterwards, because that ending was just
what?
Yeah.
Seriously, I guess this is Alan Wake Lutheran in Thunderball.
Man, what? Thunderball is the worst James Bond movie.
No, it's not the worst. There are so many James Bond movies.
James Bond does not need to resort to blackmailing women to get them into bed.
Yeah, that was a little rapey. 60s!
See, a woman looks at James Bond, and it doesn't matter what her common sense says, she sees James Bond, and her panties just drop to the floor. That's how it's supposed to work.
What about Alan Wake's American Nightmare?
Alan Wake's American Nightmare is
an entirely separate game. It's
connected.
It's supposed to be like a book written by Alan Wake, right? Like, it takes place in...
It's complicated. It's more of an action game.
Right.
And it deals with Mr. Scratch.
Oh, okay.
Though we do see Mr. Scratch again in one of the specials, I think.
Yes, Mr. Scratch is a continuing character in the specials, actually.
Oh, don't mind him. That's just Mr. Scratch.
Yeah.
Who? What?
Yeah, that just seems so out of nowhere.
Don't mind him. That's just ominous foreshadowing. That's a sequel tease.
We're going to add a loose end right here at the end of the game.
Just because. you know.
Well, okay, otherwise it would be a sudden stop.
Yep.
And on that note...
on that note, it's less than a minute until time to go off, so we should probably
departure.
Go ahead and... Yeah, time for departure. Time to go ahead and sign off. Up next is DJ Mon. Stick around, watch him. I'll be back next Thursday with
somebody.
This Week in History. And then next Saturday again for Throne of Games. So stick around, watch DJ Mon. Come back later, watch and listen to me some more. I would love that. So good night, everybody.
Watch your foot. You're in my way. You watch my foot.